own personal history with this. I was a migraine sufferer for years and years and years. And I went to doctors, dentists, nutritionists, anything that had an ist on the end, I went there, and nothing worked. And so I thought, okay, well, I just have migraines for the rest of my life. But I fell into doing this lesson once, and I heard a big crack in my head. And I haven't had a migraine or headache since. And that was 15 years ago, so that's how... So it's as I said, it's kind of the first section is specifically for the jaw. People often don't know they have jaw tightness until somebody tells them. There's teeth grinding, and sometimes your jaw is even working at night time when your teeth grind or do whatever. So this lesson is for headaches, sinus problems, jaw problems. That's the kind of the medical side of it. It also has the benefit of plumping up the collagen and making you look 10 years younger. So the first section is specifically for the jaw. So let's just begin lying down again, and we'll have another quick body scan. Have your arms down by your sides. And just get a sense of how you are resting on the floor. Notice your breathing. Notice if you are more aware of yourself than you were 2 hours ago, more or less, when we started. And then just take your attention now to how is your head resting on the floor. Are you aware of your face? Sounds like a weird question. sometimes we're not always aware of things until they are painful or uncomfortable, but can you sense if your chin is where your chin is? Can you sense where your nose is? Does your nose feel as though it's in the middle of your face? Can you sense where your eyes are? Can you sense where your ears are situated? So with this lesson, just do the movements maybe, you know, 4 times. Don't do anything that hurts you. Again, you can always imagine the movement. Obviously, all the movements are going to be quite small because you're dealing with your face and your jaw. If you want to have your knees bent and your feet standing, please do. Make yourself comfortable. And don't worry about what you look like on the floor. no one can see you. So just bring yourself into your own little bubble of awareness. And I'd like you then, please bend your knees if you want to, if you feel comfortable. And I'd like you to begin a movement by slowly opening your mouth several times. So imagine that you're watching yourself in slow motion. So open your mouth very slowly and then close it. And I'd like you to observe the effort that it is taking for you to do that. So the mouth, tongue, the jaw work really, really hard. And we're going to try to bring some awareness that might help the workload a little bit. So again, just slowly, less, and do less than you can. When you've explored that, just pause and take a brief rest. And then we're going to continue to open our mouth now, but this time I'd like you to use your tongue. So push your tongue against your lower jaw to open your mouth. So you're using your tongue now to do the effort. So just bring put the tongue down in the base of the mouth to open the jaw. Just a few times, just explore that. You might notice that it makes it easier to open the jaw. So just pause. And then we're going to continue opening our jaw or our mouth, but this time you're going to bring your tongue outside of the mouth, over the lower lip, and open the jaw with the tongue pushing downwards. So bring your tongue out over the lip and use your tongue again to open the lower jaw. So you're opening your mouth. Does it help you to get a wider opening? And then just pause, take a complete rest. Now the next movement is quite unusual, unless you are a Charlie Brown, a cartoon character. You notice when they laugh or cry, their top jaw comes away from the bottom jaw, so it's almost as if their head opens up. Maybe I'm the only one old enough to remember Charlie Brown, I don't know. So we're going to do a movement now where you're going to take your upper jaw away from the lower jaw. So to do that, I'd like you to bring your hands to your chin. You're going to hold your chin in place. All right, so just grip your chin. And then I'd like you just to begin by opening your mouth so your upper jaw separates from the lower jaw. So your chin stays in place, you're keeping your lower jaw in the same place, and then the upper jaw opens up. And so you'll probably notice that your head will tip back a little bit, so you're looking behind you even, or not. And then just close your jaw again, bring yourself back to normal. And just try that a few times. Keep holding that jaw. And separate the top jaw away from the bottom jaw. Your head will just slowly move backwards. You might even find your eyes naturally open to look behind you. It's actually quite a nice movement to do. And then just pause, bring your hands down, just take a brief rest. And now let's glide our jaw, the lower jaw, from side to side.